The more we go into the show, the more I lose hope that we're going to see some hawks in this. So episode 4 starts where we left it, with Jack holding a sword to Clint's throat, which I thought was to reveal that Jack is a bad guy, but I forgot that people would probably try and protect their homes from intruders. He does put the sword away once he realises he's Agent Sterling Archer, or maybe it's because there were other people in the room too. Who knows, the mystery thickens and whether he's a villain or not. He's just a really big red herring that's getting shoved right in your face, so now your face smells of fish, and nobody wants to be friends with Fish Face except for this one person who really likes fish, and he wants to sniff your face every chance he gets, and you want them to stop and leave you alone, but they're the only person who'll stick with you. But then you do tell them to leave, and now you're all alone, and you feel awful, so you go to the sea and drown yourself, except you don't drown, because the smell never came from the red herring, it came from you, because you were a fish disguised as a human the whole time, and now you're living your best life in the ocean, until you come across some plastic and die. Have any of you noticed how in all of these Disney Marvel shows there's been twist villains who were behind everything the whole time? With WandaVision it was Agatha, Falcon the Winter Soldier had Sharon as the Power Broker, Loki had the One Who Remains, and Hawkeye has Mephisto. I'm telling you, the hand belongs to Mephisto. If you put a red filter over it, the hand becomes red, and Mephisto's hands are red, and nothing in the show so far has denied this, which means I'm right. But wouldn't it be great if the big bad of the season was introduced in the first episode and not revealed as a surprise in the finale? So after talking to Kate's mum, Clint gets the Ronin sword, but before that, she asks Clint if he's got any kids, which makes me think that if she is a villain, then she's probably planning on doing something to his family if he doesn't drop the investigation that Kate and him are doing on the murder of Armand III. Eleanor seems kinda shady, so it's probably best to turn some lights on. Get it? Because shady is shadows, means there's no light, so put some lights on. This is the part where you're meant to laugh, so why aren't you laughing? Clint's wife does find out that Jack is the CEO of a company that commits money laundering, which they treat as evidence that he's a bad guy, but all he's doing is cleaning money by having a money laundering, which I think is good because money is kinda dirty with how so many people touch it, and who knows where those hands have been. We get some Clint and Kate bonding, and then Clint brings up how they need to track down trick arrows, which he used in the last episode, but Kate says they're our arrows. What's this? Sharing? This show's promoting communism? So anyway, Kate gets the arrows back by going to the LARPers and asking one of the police officers there to get them from the evidence room. The LARPers then offer to make costumes for him, so we most likely will see the Hawkeye comic look in the finale, maybe. I honestly don't care because I don't think it'd look good in live action, but I could be proven wrong, who knows. The both of them then go to Maya's place to try and get the watch because it's linked to someone's identity. At first, I thought the watch belonged to Tony. You know the one in Civil War, which can turn into the Iron Man gauntlet? But if it's tied to someone's identity and it could expose them, then I guess it's probably someone else. Maybe Laura? She could have been a S.H.I.E.L.D. agent or something. I don't know why the watch would be at the Avengers place, but yeah, it could be Laura's. Or it could be someone we've never met before. So they get the watch, but then Maya comes in and attacks Kate, but whilst they fight, Clint has to fight a Black Widow assassin, but who could this person be? They're wearing a mask. Could it be Mephisto? Kingpin? No, it's Yelena. Remember that part in Black Widow where... Never mind, nobody remembers that movie. So Clint realises that it's become too dangerous for Kate to stick around, so he sends her off, and then the episode ends. Right, so there's a lot of parallels in this episode, which you probably already noticed. Like when Kate was hanging off a building, it was like that Vormir scene, and it even used the same score, but the only reason she was hanging off a building and not dead was because Yelena went out of her way to attach a rope to her as she threw her off, so she's away from the fight, which makes me think that Kate's mum talked to Val, who talked to Yelena, about killing Clint, but also to make sure nothing happens to Kate. Obviously, you could say her target was Clint, and she didn't want anyone caught in the crossfire. I could be remembering this wrong, but Yelena uses her gauntlets to tase both Maya and Clint, but not Kate, so I have to assume that it was Eleanor who hired Yelena to take out Clint, but also make sure Kate was okay. There's more things in this episode that I could talk about, but why do that when I could tell you to subscribe, leave a like, you could leave a dislike, but what's the point when nobody can see it? Unless you have a plugin installed, which I'll link in the description, along with a few other things which you should also click on. Like these videos, which are on screen right now. They're not linked in the description, they're on screen, so click on them. Also, there's a subscribe button right there, in the middle of those two videos, so yeah. Alright, see ya.